Welcome to another episode of FieldFox Fundamentals. I'm David and this is Jake. And today we're actually continuing a video from last time where within our RTSA lab, we discovered that there was an interfering signal pulsing at a certain frequency. Today we're going to use the pulse measurement capabilities of the FieldFox to really characterize that pulse and just take a deeper look at what's really going on.
The FieldFox's pulse measurement app is primarily used for aerospace and defense applications, and it's Keysight's portable solution for making radar measurements.
Yeah, and as a portable solution, we're hoping to, get a lot of information about a pulse. And so the kinds of things that we can get from that are the peak average power, the peak power, the rise and fall time, the periodicity of the pulse, as well as the pulse length. Just a full gamut of information that you really want to know about your pulse. So with that in mind, why don't we take a look at that pulse that we were talking about from a previous video with the FieldFox's pulse measurement app.
So now we've set up a USB power sensor and an antenna, and we've connected this to our FieldFox. And we're going to use this to measure the pulse that we saw in last episode. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to pulse measurement, and we're going to set up our FieldFox to be measuring the same frequency as the pulse that we're trying to measure. And next, we're going to make sure that our measurement duration is long enough so that we see multiple pulse widths on the screen. And finally, we're going to click Marker Tools, Auto Analysis On, and this gives us a nice display on the screen to look at our measurements.
And there's a wealth of information that's apparent on this table. Everything from our average power to peak power to our rise and fall time to our duty cycle, we're able to characterize the pulse that we really weren't able to do in our previous lab when just looking at our real-time spectrum analyzer. So if you want to learn more about making pulse measurements and just pulse measurements in general, we have an app note down in the description that you should check out, and you can learn a whole lot right there, so please check it out.
So give us a like, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and we'll try to answer any questions that you have in the comments section. See you next time.